Hello friends, welcome to Tech Study Cell. In the last tutorial, we have controlled the appliances remotely using the ESP-NOW protocol. Now in this project, the Master ESP32 will create its own access point. So we just have to enter an IP to connect with the access point to control the relay from our smartphone laptop. Here you can see you can connect multiple smartphone laptop to control the relays, and you will always get the real-time feedback on your smartphone. In this way, we can also increase the total range for controlling the relays. You don't need any external Wi-Fi connection. You don't have to install any IoT app. Everything is free, so anyone can make it. Now, before going to the details, let me give you a quick demo. Here you can see this is the master circuit and this is the slave circuit. These appliances are connected with the slave ESP32. Here the master ESP32 will create an access point. I have already connected with that access point from my smartphone. And as the slave status connected, so you can able to control the relays with this dashboard. Here you can see all the relays are on. We can also control the relay from the master circuit. And on the OLED you can see currently all the relays are on. Let me turn off the relays. First two relays are off and we can monitor the real-time feedback on my smartphone. Now if I tap this button, all the relays will turn off together. And here you can see I can also control the relay from the slave circuit. Let me turn on the third relay, and as the slave is connected, we can monitor the feedback on the smartphone. Now let me turn it off. Now let me turn off the supply for the slave. Slave is not connected with the power supply, and here you can see it's showing disconnected. And if I see the master circuit, on the OLED it is showing no feedback, check slave. Now let me turn on the supply for the slave again, and first it will try to connect with the slave. If it is connected, the blue LED will turn on and we can monitor the real-time feedback. Now as it is connected, we can able to control the relay with the master circuit and also with the web interface. So this is a very useful project, and here you can see I can able to control the relays from outside with my smartphone. During the video, I have explained all the steps, so after watching the complete video, anyone can make it. So without any further delay, let's get started. This video is sponsored by Altium, which is the most trusted PCB designer software by all the big electronic companies. With Altium, you can easily search for components, compare the datasheet, and it has a lot of useful features that will save you a lot of time while routing any complex PCB. Now Altium has come up with an amazing product called Altium 365. Altium 365 is an electronic product design platform that unites PCB design, MCAD, data management and teamwork. With Altium 365, you can not only design PCBs, you can also share your projects with your teammates for review. It also provides automatic backup, centralized cloud storage and a lot more. There are many tutorials available on Altium, so you can easily learn this software and use it to design professional PCBs. And you can download the Altium Designer free trial with Altium 365 from the link in the description. Afterwards, if you decide to purchase the software, you will get 25% off if you have signed up through my link. So please visit the link in the description, sign up for the Altium. It's a limited time offer, so please hurry up. To make this project, you just need two ESP32, 4-channel relay module, some push buttons and a OLED. Now let's move to the master circuit. In the master circuit, I have just connected these push buttons across the GPIO pins and ground. And to monitor the feedback from the slave, I have connected this OLED with the master. Then in the slave circuit, again I have connected these push buttons across the GPIO pins and ground, and here I have used active low relay module. So the circuit is very simple, you can make it without using any PCB, but here for the master I have made the circuit on this 0 PCB, and for the slave I am going to use this PCB just to avoid any loose connection. Now let me move to the coding part of this project. These are the source code for this project. You can download all the source code from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article, you can find the link in the description. Then you can download all the source code from these buttons. And in the same article, I have also explained the code line by line. So if you have any query, you can always refer to this article. Now first we have to get the MAC address both from the master and slave ESP32. For that I am going to upload this get MAC address code to both master and slave ESP32. I have already explained it in my previous video. So if you know this step, you can directly jump to next step. So let me open this cache with Arduino IDE. Then let me connect the master ESP32 first. So in the code, it will just print the MAC address on serial monitor. So I will select the board, do it ESP32 dev kit, then select the COM port, then I will hit the upload button. After uploading the code, I will open the serial monitor, then I will just press the reset button, and this is the MAC address for the master. I will just copy it, then paste it in a notepad. In a similar way, let me connect the slave ESP32 with my laptop. Then again, I will upload the same code to slave. After uploading, again, I will open the serial monitor, press the reset button to get the MAC address of slave. So this is the MAC address of slave. I will copy the MAC address, then paste it in a notepad. After getting the two MAC address, let me close the sketch. Now I will connect the master ESP32 with the laptop again. Then I will open this sketch. ESP-NOW master 4 relay. So let me open it with Arduino IDE. For this project, I have used this version of the ESP32 and you need to install these libraries. I have also mentioned the version and related link. Then here I have entered the width and height of the OLED which I have used. So if you use different model of the OLED, you have to mention the width height accordingly. Then this is the name of the access point and the password. Here the ESP32 will create its own access point. So if you want, you can change the name and password accordingly. Then these GPIOs are connected with the manual push button. Then here I have defined the feedback timeout 4 seconds. As per the logic, slave will send feedback every 2 seconds to master. Master will wait till 4 seconds. Within 4 seconds, if it not receive any feedback from the slave, it will assume slave is not connected. So here I have defined the value 4 seconds as feedback timeout. Then this is the HTML content for the web interface. Here I have used JSON API thoughtful UI to make the web page more interactive. So you can monitor the real-time feedback, slave connection status live on this web interface. Then with this callback function, we are sending data to slave. Then with this function, we are displaying the data on the OLED. So if you go through the code, you can easily understand. And I have also explained the code line by line in the same article. You can find the link in the description. Now let me upload this code to master ESP32. So here you can see I have selected the proper board and COM port. Now let me hit the upload button. Now I will connect the slave ESP32 with my laptop. Then I will open this sketch ESP-NOW slave 4 relay with Arduino IDE. In the code you can also see slave ESP-NOW control 4 relay. So this is the sketch for the slave. Here I have mentioned the GPIOs connected with the relay control pin, and here I have used active low relay module. Then these GPIOs are connected with the manual push button connected with the slave circuit. Then here I have to enter the MAC address for the master ESP32. So I will go to notepad, copy the MAC address of the master ESP32. Then here I will paste it. So don't forget to update the MAC address of the master ESP32 here. Then in the code, here you can see with this function, we are toggling the relay state as per the data received from the master. Then we are sending the feedback to master so that we can monitor it on the OLED. Then with this handle button press function, we are checking if any manual button press in the slave circuit and accordingly controlling the relays and sending the feedback to master. So the code is very simple, you can easily understand. Again, you can refer to the article if you have any query, link in description. Now let me go to tools, select the do it ESP32 dev kit board and the proper COM port, then hit the upload button. After programming, first let me give the power supply to master circuit, and on the OLED you can see first it is trying to connect with the slave ESP32. As the slave has no power supply, so it is showing no feedback, check slave. Now let me turn on the supply for the slave, and as soon as the slave connected with the master circuit,
The blue LED turns on and we can monitor the real-time feedback on the OLED. Currently all the relays are off. Now first let me try to turn on first and second relay. Here you can see the first two relays are on. Now let me turn on the third relay from the slave circuit, then fourth relay, and as soon as the relays turn on we can monitor the feedback on the OLED. Currently all the relays are on. Now I will open the web interface. So let me turn on the Wi-Fi. First I have to connect with the access point created by the master ESP32. Then I will search for the access point name ESP32 relay. Let me tap on it. Then I have to enter the password 1234567 8. After that I will open the Google Chrome. Then here I have to enter the IP http 192.168.41. Let me tap on the IP. Now this is our dashboard. Currently all the relays are on. So here you can see all the relays are on. Let me turn off the first two relay. So here you can see first two relay turns off, and we can also monitor it on the master circuit. Here you can see first two relays are off. Now let me turn off the fourth relay from the master circuit. You can see the fourth relay turns off here on the OLED, and we can also monitor it on the web interface. Here you can see, and here you can see the fourth relay is off. Now let me turn off the third relay from the slave circuit. So currently all the relays are off. We can monitor it on the web interface, and on the OLED here you can see all the relays are off. So this is a very useful project, and in future I will try to control the master ESP32 over the internet with different IoT platform. So if you find this project helpful, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.